వందే పర్ణగభూషణం శశిధరం వందే పశూనాం పతిం వందే సూర్యశశాంకవల్లినయనం వందే బృందప్రియం వందే భక్తజనాశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే భక్తజనాశ్రయం చ వరదం వందే శివం శంకరం. ఫ్రెండ్స్, యోగా అండ్ ఈగో కెనాట్ గో టుగెదర్. యోగా వి ఆర్ ఫెమిలియర్ విత్, ఈగో ఆల్సో ఈస్ విత్ అస్. అహంకార, ఐ ఆమ్ సో అండ్ సో, ఐ ఆమ్ ఎ గ్రేట్ మ్యాన్, ఐ ఆమ్ ఎ నాలెడ్జియబుల్ పర్సన్, ఐ ఆమ్ ఎ స్కాలర్, I am the president, I am the prime minister, I am X, Y, Z. This boastfulness is a quality of egoism. Ahankara is vibrant in some, is hidden in some, is sometimes expressed, but nobody is free from egoism. Yoga is meant to remove egoism. Yoga is meant to annihilate egoism. Yoga is meant to eradicate egoism. Ego and yoga cannot live together. Kama, Rama cannot coexist. Rama is love, Ravana is lust. Kama is lust, Rama is pure prema. Ram and Kama cannot coexist. There can never be hot ice. If it is hot, it cannot be ice. If it is ice, it cannot be hot. Frozen fire, if it is of a freezing point, minus degree temperature, it cannot be fire. Similarly, darkness and light cannot coexist. There are the opposites. These opposites cannot live together. Hanumanji is a person of yoga. Some characters may be of special yogic qualities, maybe Raja Yoga, maybe a Bhakta, maybe a Karma Yogi, maybe a Jnani, may be a person of total Sharanagati. Hanuman is such a wonderful character. In him, all the five yogas are in full available. There are certain people who might have specialized only in Raja Yoga. There are certain people who are great Karma Yogis. But Hanumanji is such a model character, an exemplary being, that in him yoga has completely removed that ahankara. His place is always at the feet of Sri Ram. Raja Yoga, in simple terms, is strong willpower, indomitable will, invincible courage, inexhaustible strength. These are the traits of a Raja Yogi. Hanumanji is of firmness, Vajrakaya, strong determination, powerful willpower. He does not have any diminishing strength in him, always waxing, never waning. That Anjaneya is an exemplary character for willpower. Once he decides, he does it. There is no question of going back. He decided to go to find the whereabouts of Sita Devi, and he was able to find out. He decided to be of use to Sri Ramakarya, and he executed it. A character of tremendous willpower is a Raja Yogi. In the recent past, you have Swami Vivekananda, a great Raja Yogi of strong willing power. Come what may, we do not swerve from the path laid to reach the destination. That is the strength of willpower. We do not move, drift, vary. Anjaneya Swami has decided to surrender himself at the feet of Sri Ram. His introduction in the Ramayana is wonderful. A great man of excellent discrimination and establishing himself in Jnana. Ramji and Lakshmanji are in search of Sita Devi in the woods. At a distance, they were seen by Sugriva. Sugriva was afraid of them, thinking that they were sent by Vali. He told Hanumanji, two people are coming. I am scared, I am afraid. Please find out who they are. Hanumanji, as a young brahmachari, proceeded to Ram and Lakshman. Sir, I see you at a distance. I find certain wonderful things in you. I find four contradictions in you. Number one, you look like divine personalities. You look like angels. You look like people of ethereal skies. You do not appear to be earthly beings. You look like gods. But you are walking on the earth. Your feet touch the floor. Somebody told me that the divine beings do not walk on the ground and their feet do not touch the floor. But your feet are touching. Are you divine or are you earthly? It's the first contradiction. You look like divine personalities, but you tread the earth. Two, you look like a great tapasvins of austerity, of penances, closing the nostrils, sitting under the green wood tree's shade. You must be observing penances or tapasya. Such people need not carry the bowed arrow. You have the matted hair. You have the soiled clothes. You look like austere people of great tapasya. But I find you carrying the weapons. Why should tapasvins have the weapons? This is the second contradiction. Third, you look like royal people, princes. You must be occupying the thrones. You must be the kings of kingdoms. Where is your crown? Why are you in the woods? What has happened to your kingdom? Are you royal personalities? If you, that is so, why are you in the woods? Third contradiction. Fourth, you look like Stita Prajnas. In the Bhagavad Gita 2nd chapter, Sri Krishna gives 18 stanzas describing a Stita Prajna, a person who maintains the equanimity of mind under all circumstances. But you are searching for somebody, there is anxiety seen in your eyes. Yes, Stita Prajna does not have anxiety. Yes, Stita Prajna neither seeks nor avoids. He is not interested in anything, nor is he running away from anything. Such a type of person is a Stita Prajna. Ram and Lakshman, they looked like Stita Prajnas to Hanumanji. But sir, I find you searching for someone in this forest with tension. There is a little anxiety seen in your eyes. Four contradictions. Very keen observer was Anjaneya. First observation, you are divine, your feet touch the ground. First contradiction. Second, you look like austere people of tapasya, but you carry bow and arrow. Third, you look like royal people. Why are you in the woods? Four, you look like religious souls, but there is a little anxiety seen in your eyes. Who are you, sir? And immediately Rama said, I think this man is a great pandit. I think this man is of very good use to us. Befriend him. Lakshman, this man is required for us. Such a person will be the savior of society. Such a person will be the acharya to all the students. He is sure to take any man to the highest destination. Immediately Rama was able to understand the grandeur of Anjaneya Swami. Lakshmana introduced, and Ram and Lakshman were placed on the shoulders of Anjaneya, and on the way he told about Sugriva. Sugriva presented himself, his story, his pathetic story, that his wife Rumai is stolen by Vali. When Sugriva narrated his story, Sri Ramachandra Prabhu gave the pronouncement, I shall kill your brother Vali. Is he right as a judge? He must have taken the other man's version also. You cannot take the judgment, you cannot pass the judgment listening to one person. There lies the greatness of Sri Ramachandra Prabhu. Tell me your friends what type of man you are, I will tell you. When Anjaneya Swami is associated with Sugriva, Sugriva cannot afford to be a bad man. If Sugriva is wrong, Anjaneya will not be with him. Your witness is powerful. Your witness is noble. Your witness is a grand personality. Anjaneya Swami is with you. Therefore, I believe your version and I pass the judgment. I shall punish the wicked fellow. Anjaneya, if he is by our side, it is a testimony to our character. He will not befriend anybody if a person is wrong. Hanumanji is such a great person of self-determination. That very moment, he decided that he would submit his all at the feet of Ram, strong willpower. And he is such a great karma yogi. Never did he aspire for any particular fruit or recognition. At the end, when Pattabhisheka was taking place, everybody was given a gift. Some were given Bharataratna, some were given Padma Bhushan, some were given Padma Vibhushan. Whoever was responsible for the success of a particular party, that Prime Minister would give all the awards to his people. And Sri Ramachandra Prabhu went on giving awards to Vibhishan, Sugriva, Angad, Jambavan, and a host of others. Anjaneya was not given. Sita Devi wanted him to be given an award. Ram said, he is a karma yogi requiring no recognition. And his place was near the feet of Ram. The greatest work was done by Anjaneya Swami in the Ramayana. He saved the lives of Ram, Lakshman, Bharat. When Sita Devi was about to commit suicide, it was Anjaneya who saved her from the attempt. Such a great personality, such a great contributor to the glory of the Ramayana is not given an award. A karma yogi seeks no recognition. A karma yogi seeks no reward, no titles, no certificates, no testimonials. And the gentleman just sat at the feet of Hanumanji, Sri Ramji. A great person of knowledge, a great person of service and devotion. Anywhere, anybody, if a person sings Ramlil, Deh Yatra Yatra Raghunath Kirtanam, Tatra Tatra Kritamasta Kanjali, Bhashpavari Paripurna Lochanam, Ramaru Dinavata Rakshasantakam, such a person Even if we say Ram, Ready me, Anjaneya will be by our side. Even Ram may come a little late, but Hanumanji is by our side. Such is the great devotion, melting the hearts and melting the minds. He will float in the skies, admiring the great glory of Ramachandra Prabhu. Such is the exultant devotion that Anjaneya has. He will be always in ecstasies. He will be entering into a state of trance the moment he remembers Sri Ram, such a great devotee. And then you will find him to be a great Advaitanubhuti person. Once Sri Ram asked Anjaneya, how do you look at me? And Anjaneya says, when I have the Dehatma Buddhi, you are my boss, I am your servant. Dasya Bhakti I am your servant. When I go beyond that to Jivatma Buddhi, you are the whole, I am the part. That is a Vishishtadvaitic concept. When I still go higher, deeper, stronger, Tvameva Aham, Ahameva Tvam. There is no difference between you and me. We merge with each other. And Sri Ramachandra Prabhu was so much delighted to listen to that, he hugs him. There is no difference. A devotee goes to the heights, Salokyam, Samipyam, Sarupyam, Sayudhyam, merge with the highest. And as Rajyogi of V-power, as Karmayogi of service, as a Bhakta of highest devotion, finally he merges with the Almighty. Total self-surrender Sharanagati. Beautifully the interpreters say, he plays the role of an excellent Acharya. When Sri Ramachandra Prabhu gave his Angulika ring, it is a symbolic of bringing God's protection to the devotee. He is the great man. His Angulika ring I have brought symbolically conveying his protection to you. Abhayam. Abhayam dadami sarva bhuteshu etat vratam mama is the principle of Sri Rama. Whoever seeks protection, whoever is helpless, whoever offers his prayers to me, I shall readily come and offer my protection. And that is Sri Ramachandra's principle. And that principle is there with a person somewhere in America who is to convey that message to me. It is Acharya. It is Anjaneya Acharya. He plays the role of a messenger, rather Acharya, from God to devotee and from devotee to God. From Sri Ramachandra Prabhu, he brought that ring. From God, he brought that Abhayahasta. And in Ashokavana, she is weeping devotee. He gave that ring to Sita, offering the protection of the Almighty. And in turn, she gave her Chudamani. Chudamani is a head ornament. Thank you, Acharya Ji. You have shown me the solace, you have shown me the destination, you have given me the Abhayahasta of my Lord, you have brought the solace message of soothing nature. Here is my head, I am offering it to you. This is total self-surrender. Sita Devi's surrender is devotee's self-surrender, Sharanagati. Rama's ring being brought is the message of Abhayahasta being brought. From the God he brings protection, from the devotee he takes Sharanagati. He unites them both, he brings them together, and this is the role of a great Acharya. All the wonderful roles allotted to him, he has played very well. This Prashant Kubir is specializing four yogas, Raja Yoga, Anjaneya has. Bhakti, Anjaneya has. Karma Anjaneya has. Jnani, whatever he speaks is of profound wisdom. There is no shallow speech. There is no useless talk. And excellent Vichakshana Jnana Anjaneya has. And powerful, wise expressions he makes. Such is Anjaneya. Everywhere knowledge is seen. Finally, he merges his ego. Godavari is a river with a form, with a name. When it goes to the sea, the form is lost, name is lost. It is no more Godavari. Its waters also change. They merge with the sea water and become salty. Ganga has her own quality of water and her own name. Both the form and name are lost the moment Ganga merges with the sea. Similarly, Yamuna, all the rivers lose their names, lose their forms, because they have to merge with the ocean. Ocean is almighty, sea is the God, and when we merge with the almighty, we lose our ahankara identity. Anjaneya is a symbolic personality of total self-surrender. Anyatha sharanam nasti tvameva sharanam mama. Bhagavad Gita ends with the sloka, sarva dharmam parityajya mam ekam sharanam vraja, aham tva sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami masuchaha. I shall give you self-realization. I shall give you God-realization. I shall absorb you in me. I shall assimilate you in me. You merge with me, you become one with me. And you find in the character of Anjaneya, the real yoga, the model yogi, all comprehensive yoga, holistic yoga, all the five yogas, Raja Yoga, Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Jnana Yoga, and Prapatti Yoga is Sharanagati. All of them are put into one, all the five are in one. He has been playing that role right from the times immemorial, since Treta Yuga till today. Anjaneya Swami has been a model yogi. Today is Hanuma Jayanti. We have to remember such a grand bhakta, karma yogi, and a jnani, especially this particular university, which is dedicated to all aspects and dimensions of yoga, must have the role model, and that role model is Sri Anjaneya, Acharya Anjaneya. His Jayanti is being celebrated today. Some people celebrated it yesterday, some people celebrated it today. Let us all, for 30 seconds, sit in meditation, remember that Anjaneya Swami, let our minds flow in devotion to his feet, let us absorb a little bit of Anjaneya Swami's yoga practices, let us try to be inspired by his wonderful personality.
Asato ma sadgamaya.